MCT 143. Mm-hmm. That is a labor of love for you.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit how that was born and some of the benefits of taking that.
Coconut oil is the richest natural source of MCTs, medium chain triglycerides. Bodybuilders had been using it for something like 40 years to increase lean body mass. So it had been around for that reason. Japan, they were studying it for weight loss to use to help control weight for 30, 40 years, you know.
Wow.
So other uses of it. The difference between young, healthy adults and cognitively healthy older adults is that there's a gap between how much energy the brain needs and how much it gets of about 7%. Wow. That, you know, and our brains start to shrink a little bit from the time we're in our late 30s, maybe even earlier. Every year it shrinks a little bit, and it's conceivable that this gap in how much energy our brain is getting might be partly responsible for that. It's taking MCT oil, for example. Ketones produced from that can help fill in that energy gap. MCT oil is more ketogenic than coconut oil. It tends to increase ketone levels higher. So I started mixing it, and I found that a 4-to-3 ratio of MCT oil to coconut oil worked very well. It stayed liquid at room temperature. It didn't separate. We could use it in almost any food. I was also adding some soy lecithin to it, which is like an emulsifier. It helps mix it, but it also has these brain phospholipids, phosphatidylcholine being the most important and the most abundant. And so MCT 143 came quite a bit later, about 9 years later. I was just very grateful that Brian Underwood, the CEO of Pruvit, approached me about why don't we make an oil instead of the soy lecithin, because it has other things in it, trying to get the phosphatidylcholine in a pure concentrated form, you know, into MCT 143. I was, you know, something that we agreed that we could do with it, you know, which is really cool. Phosphatidylcholine is very abundant in the brain. It's abundant in every cell membrane, and it's about 40% of the fats in cell membranes in the brain. And it's also part of it, the choline part of it becomes part of a neurotransmitter called acetylcholine. And acetylcholine is important to memory. Taking phosphatidylcholine can help replenish some of that, that may be lacking in the brain. And I'm just, you know, very pleased because, you know, people can easily take it with them anywhere. I'm just really excited, you know, to have this available now.
Well, we're super thankful for you.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for
welcome.
Hanging out with us and being here with us.
Oh, you're welcome.
You're awesome.
Thank you for asking me to do this.